feeling alive.
After a layover with the Emirates crew in Osaka, reliving the emotions of my old times in Emirates, I'm off to the next city of Japan that gets me a mix of experiences that I was not expecting at all.
This is amazing.
There's a vegan place that closes in 15 minutes, 14 minutes actually. So I hope I don't have to get food from one of those machines. Otherwise I'm gonna be fasting. As I was leaving the hotel, I was feeling a bit lost, a bit confused. And I think it was obviously the situation where I'm at now. It's very free, but unstable as well at the same time. But I think is that, wow, so cool like this. But I think that it was also because I was in a layover, like it was when I was working in Emirates. I spent the flight with them, I spent the layover with them, I was at the same hotel. I left more or less at the wake-up call, but instead of going back to work, then I took a train. I took my stuff and took the train. So I think that was a bit confusing to me. But now, seeing that there's less people here and being just free and going anywhere that I want, wow, so excited, mama. It's amazing. It's closed. I don't think it's even open ever, you know. And I gotta say that I feel like now it's okay, 10 p.m., not that late, but I feel so safe. It's like, yeah, I don't even look, I can let go of my bag and not even needing to look. Wow, even more than Dubai, almost. Yeah, I feel safer than Dubai. That's crazy. Dubai is safe, really safe. Even the Mac is closed, like closes at 9. Yeah, that's the thing, you know, I feel like I need to live somewhere that things are opened a bit longer than 9 p.m. I'm a bit spoiled maybe, you know, like I love New York lifestyle and Dubai as well, anytime. That's it, bro, like this. Broccoli and basil. And fries as well.
So excited. Almost 10. Yeah, my plan was to wake up at 7:30, but yeah, didn't make that one. Not feeling bad about it, and just appreciating the present moment. The quality of the air is amazing as well. You can feel the freshness. World, here I am. This is simply amazing. Wow, look at this one. And the lady now in the bicycle was gonna stop, like, just because I'm making a video. Like, how amazing are you Japanese people? How amazing. Oh my god, I'm so in love into this place. Walking towards a place where I wanted to go. It's an abandoned kind of Disneyland, and it's called Dreamland. you're not supposed to enter. However, many people enter, but that's not an excuse to make it a ride. Unfortunately, in 2016, it has been demolished, a good part of it. I can see that people still go and there's still things to see inside.
The park was the main competitor to Disneyland and was actually very similar to it. Dreamland was active since 1961 until 2006, when it officially closed its doors, possibly due to the new openings of Disneyland right there in Tokyo. And the fact that the park was left abandoned for over 10 years...
It's already a well-known thing here in Nara. You know, I have like 7 hours, it's 11 a.m. now, before going to Kyoto. So I'm gonna go try and see how it looks like. The kids coming back from school, how awesome. 500. How clean, it is so spotless. It's amazing, it's just such a pleasure just to be anywhere. Anywhere, and look, like the kids running around. I feel like it's Doraemon, the cartoon. and the thing that is blowing my mind, it's actually how inexpensive things are here. I mean, this accommodation, I preferred it much more than the first hotel that I stayed in, to be honest. Like, the first hotel, I paid 180 euros plus just a coffee and taxes. It became 197 euros. For one night, okay? And a coffee and espresso. But here, I paid 19 euros with coffee included. Like, how nuts is the difference? And I prefer this so much more. The bathroom is so clean, and maybe because I've been spending so many nights in regular hotels, you know, that I'm kind of just used to it. It's not like in Western countries, where in the hostels there's so much noise, there's not much respect. Actually, I was the one that was making the most amount of noise, you know? So I felt a little bad. So it's actually a very high standard, one of the hostels as well. Uh-oh, I see a Starbucks. That looks like a beautiful Starbucks, I gotta say. Like, one of a kind.
Yeah, it's quite challenging to find beans, actually. Apparently it's because there has been a terrorism attack. Japan then removed all the beans.
But let me tell you more about this, because it's actually a very important event. In 1995, 5 bags of the gas sarin were strategically placed in different places of the Tokyo subway center system, taking over 13 lives and injuring thousands of people. Since then, beans were completely removed, or at least the styles that we were used to see.
I think that's where it starts.
So this should be the park on the right. Let's see if I find a hole in the fence. Should have gone early in the morning. Should have woken up earlier. Is this a hole? Yeah, that's a freaking hole. I don't know, I feel a little skeptical. I could climb there, but I think the hole is better. Let's do it.
The backpack is getting stuck. Look at how tall the grass is.
Ooh. Is this really a good choice? I don't think this is a good choice.
Voices though, and I think I managed
to move further in. Very skeptical. It's wide open.
I was waiting and seeing how it looked like. Fun and then allergy attack. Even because I hear voices, doesn't feel right, to be honest. So I think I'm gonna go out inside the pollen again. Mamma mia. Okay, I'm out. Made it. I waited until I heard no cars. Then I climbed fast. I mean, my body's itching. Didn't have one of those reactions like this for a while. Mamma mia, I'm risking it actually, I think, because it was very intense, like pollen everywhere. 1 hour later. This is amazing. What?
Vegan tiramisu? Like, where, when, how? That's not even in Italy. So thoughtful. I'm the only foreigner here. There's no one else. They're all Japanese.
Is Starbucks not having foreigners? Maybe because they're all going to the local places, not to Starbucks. For me, this is winning in life. Oh my God, I feel so happy, so content. It's actually also the freedom. I can just do anything. Anything I want, anything. I ever feel like I want to cry of joy and happiness. Oh my God.
Even a little wipe, like a wet wipe, it's super helpful. Yeah, because you might get dirty eating, you know? Like small things, you know? That even in other countries should be done, you know? This is amazing. It's quite late, I gotta say. The main thing is that I can't walk that fast. That's why. They're all walking, but is it normal? Yeah, I can't spread my legs that much. I need to walk very slow. And yeah, that's not very convenient, I gotta say. I clearly understand why many Asians, they walk like this. Small steps and fast. There's a deer. Oh my dear.
I don't have any food for you. Sorry.
A question you might have in your mind is, but you're alone, don't you even feel awkward in all this? And yes I do, but I just embrace it and love it so much. Actually, I enjoy the awkwardness now, the being uncomfortable for the experience, because I love it, loving it, being alone, like, wow, enhances the uncomfortableness like a ton. But wow, it's so beautiful.
Thank you.
don't have anything. I don't have anything. I don't have anything. Hey, Bob.
How awesome is this? So cute.
But why do I smell weed?
Those kids don't seem to have a normal face. There's something in the ice cream.
Lovely lady, that one. Japanese, took me a nice picture. Not too bad, right? I love being here. Who knows? I'm gonna check the rent. I don't have any cookie. Okay, never mind. Man, I gotta say, here is pretty spectacular. How crazy. Wow. Thank you. Practicing gratitude and being in the present now. It's so fulfilling, and I would say that it's easier to do this when you are in a holiday, in a new place, in a new country, and obviously that you enjoy, because back home we have so many of the habits that might be not the healthiest one, maybe not the best for us. Either they remind us of the past, or we project them in the future into something that we would like to be in a different way. Something that I feel it's important in our daily life, in order to stay connected with our within and to our source. Because that's ultimately a way, at least for me, to keep enjoying every day and appreciate the small things and appreciate the big things. Being present is something that, if it's not there, you lose the purpose. And that's what happened to me for this past year and a half, I would say. I started to lose the purpose, even though there was a goal, but that doesn't mean it's a purpose, right? Nobody.
Hello.
Bye bye.
I can say that I'm putting it into the top countries that I prefer, my favorite countries. It's because of different reasons. Obviously, the country is beautiful. The weather now, it's perfect. It gets really cold actually in the winter. Because I've been in the winter, I didn't know that the weather could be this amazing. Obviously in the summer, I guess it's quite warm. But not only for tourism, but even for living. Like, there's everything you need. I've seen some gyms, I'm gonna go to the gym in the next days. There's respect, there's politeness. Tax system, I don't know how it is yet. I'm gonna research and put it down and into perspective and analyze it. This one is a typical store where they make the mochi, or they actually heat it. I was hoping to find them making it, but they are not, clearly. Oh, how amazing. Gotta say, I feel so blessed for having this freedom. Now I'm gonna go to Kyoto, and I have this freedom to be able to move around just because of the systems that are making money for me, you know? I wouldn't be able to do it otherwise. Yes, YouTube is bringing an income, but as you might have seen, we didn't publish for over 3 months, almost 4 months, So that wasn't the primary source of income anymore. And trading is now. So I'm grateful for that, because otherwise I wouldn't be able to be here.
As I sit down and relax on the train before another allergy reaction explodes, I truly say thank you to the universe for every detail of my life and for the wonderful day that I had here in Nara. And I want to say thank you to you too for watching the video until the end. If you're not already, consider subscribing to the channel. Until the next one, as always, take care and stay blessed.
Bye, dears.